OK， 下一个我们请那个 Andy Anderson 啊，来 Andy Anderson， OK， 他是 Liliana Larson， 来，从 Andy Anderson 来给我们介绍 Andy Anderson， 他也是一个导航员。
So good morning, everyone. My name is Liliana Larson. I'm a registered nurse. I've been a nurse for over 18 years. In the last 10 years, I've been working at MD Anderson in the Inland World.
他说我是他的名字，刚才就是 Liliana 哈。然后呢，他在 MD Anderson， 他做那个肿瘤的那个导航员已经做了18年了，然后在 MD Anderson 做了10年了。
I am currently a pancreatic nurse navigator, specializing on cancer of the pancreas.
他现在就是那个癌症的导航员，癌症病人的导航员，尤其是他的专业是在胰脏癌的方面。
So MD Anderson is a specialized hospital where you will find expertise because we focus only in cancer.And we've seen pretty much every case out there.
Yeah. Do you want them to help me move the slide? No,
this one's fine.
Okay. Yeah, 刚刚介绍一下说 ，Anderson 是一个专业的一个医院哈，他的专长是在那个癌症。
So I'm here today to help you understand what a navigator does and what are the services that we can offer or we can refer patients in and out of the others.
他今天的目的是想告诉你说这个导航员在病那个医院里导航员的角色是什么，那如果这个导航员怎么样去帮助你。
So here is how the Oncology Nurse Society defines a nurse navigator. And I will allow a couple of seconds for you to read. So in short, it's a nurse that has the bird's eye view of the patient's care.And help them overcome any barriers that they might encounter in the system.
他说这是根据他们的医学会的那个定义哈，那个导航员是什么的角色呢？他说他的角色就是他是第一线的帮助病人哈，去了解这整个医疗的体系，同时呢，帮助病人如果你有任何的障碍，没办法去就医的话，他们要帮忙做这些事。
So the role of the navigator is going to vary by disease site or by institution.So if you ask different navigators what they do, you're probably going to get different answers.
Oh, that's just what I'm telling you.
So depending on which hospital you go, people is going to do different.
他说那个这个他们这个医疗的导航员，就是说根据每个医院的体系的不一样，他们的角色也不一样。
So my role at MD Anderson is to educate patients, provide resources, promote informed decision making.And facilitating timely access to care.
他说他的角色在 MD Anderson 的角色就是第一个，他可以帮忙教育病人哈。第二个呢，他可以就是说找到病人哪些的问题，哪些阻碍的资源，还有呢就是要帮病人就是连接到这个他们的治疗团队，他的角色。
So most importantly is providing support on those times when the patient have more anxiety, which is usually when they request the appointment until the time they see the doctor.
他说，其实他们最重要的一个阶段就是说，他们跟连接哈，尤其在病人最刚开始最紧张、最担忧的时候，他们的角色是帮助病人跟那个真正在开始治疗之间的那个那段时间的帮忙。
Also before treatment, by explaining to them what is going to happen and to help them coordinate any logistics. A lot of our patients from all over the world, all over the United States, and there are a lot that they need to coordinate.
他说呢，还有一个就是在病人开始治疗之前啊，他们 Anderson 有病人来自世界各地啊，他说在病人治疗之前，他们在做一些协调，让病人能够很快的进入治疗。
So, for example, traveling, lodging, transportation. So, the nurse navigator will refer the patients to the resources available, or will connect them with the right individual.
对，他说，因为像 Anderson 他们有病人来自世界各地嘛，哈，所以在治疗之前，他们这些护士的导航员会做的工作就是帮助这些病人去，比如说他们从国外来。从外州来的住宿的问题啊，各方面的一些比较实际上需要帮忙安顿的问题。
We also provide assistance after treatment throughout until survivorship by helping the patient break down the information, assessing any symptoms, and just making sure that they are having the support they need.
他们也帮忙，就是即使病人在开始治疗完以后，一直到最后治疗结束啊之后，他们这段期间他们也提供一些帮忙哈，让病人在治疗的过程中有任何的问题，他们也会支持。
And the support is not just for the patients, it's also for the families. Because we need to be aware that there's such thing called caregiver burnout, that is the person providing the care also gets tired.
他们的帮忙啊，不光是说就是说帮助病人，也帮助家庭照顾者，因为照顾者常常最常会最后是什么叫崩溃，就是体力竭。所以他们的帮助对象不光只是病人，还有说他的家属也是。
So explaining the role of the navigator is kind of difficult because we do so much and we wear so many hats.
他说他要跟大家来解释这些护士的导航员的工作，他说有点难，因为呢他们戴很多帽子，有很多不同的工作，不同的性质。
So my recommendation is if you go to any institution, just ask what services are available for me, what assistance can you provide?
所以他建议大家，你要到任何一家医院的时候，最好就问一下他们这个医院说，他有没有这种这方面的工作人员可以帮助他，帮助你去了解这个医院。
And keep in mind what I said before, different institutions are going to have different services, so you might find patient navigators or coordinators,which sometimes are not nurses. You're gonna find financial navigators, and you're gonna find the financial navigators usually help with insurance and financial issues, and you also wanna find the nurse navigators.
他要再的强调，就是说每个医院啊，他们有自己不同的工作人员，就是这个导航员。那像比如说，有些医院会有一些专门财务方面的导航员。那些人会帮你解决一些像保险啊，还有财务补助这方面的问题，所以到了每一家医院就一定要问清楚，好不好？他们的导航员在哪里
？So for this presentation, I'm going to focus on the nurse navigator. So the nurse navigator is the primary point of contact when a patient is new to the institution.
他说今天他刚刚讲的就是他是护士的导航员。因为护士的导航员可能是病人到这个医院里头第一个要接触的。
And it's an additional point of contact throughout the treatment until survivorship. So the navigator never goes away. It's always available for you.
对，而且他们的导航员是从头到最后不会离开的，在这个阶段一定有不同的导航员。
So being one of the largest cancer centers in the world.MD Anderson usually utilize the latest technology and the latest treatment. So when the patients come to MD Anderson, they might be hearing terms that they never heard before. So part of the navigator is explain to the patients what that mean and help them, you know, navigate and answer any questions that they might have.
他说那个他们的护士的导航员的另外一个工作，因为像 MD Anderson 是全世界有名的癌症治疗中心。所以很多病人来的时候，他可能对那些医疗的词汇、医疗的术语根本不清楚。对他们的工作就是可能要跟另外一个工作，就是帮助病人去了解这种的医疗的治疗的这中间各种的语言上的障碍。
MD Anderson also has cutting edge research, so a lot of our therapies might be available at MD Anderson years before they are available in the community.
他说 MD Anderson 也是另外一个教学的医院。所以他们有很多的实验设计，对，临床实验，对不对？他们有很多各种临床的实验，对那些临床实验的药物，可能在社区的医院里头不见得会有，但是他们会有。
So part of my role at MD Anderson is to educate the patients and raise awareness about clinical trials.
所以他们其中的一个角色就是说，帮助病人了解、明白临床实验。
Also equipping the patients in how to ask questions, trying to explain what are the commitment for the patient to participate in the clinical trial, or to debunk any needs that they might have.
对他另外一个角色就是说，他可能要帮助他们那个护士导航员帮助MD Anderson 去教育病人关于各种的临床实验哪些的，还有些什么可能的影响啊。
Also, educating patients that if we don't have a treatment available at our facility, we can help them navigate clinicaltrials.gov to find clinical trials available for their disease.
他们还可以做一件事情，如果说这些临床实验 在他们跟耶利神没有在做的临床实验，他们可以到那个其他的网站，像 CDC 去找到有哪些临床实验可以适用的。
So I've been talking about barriers to care, and you're probably thinking, what are they?
他刚才已经讲了，就是说很多对造成看病的一些障碍，对不对？他说你可能很急，也想知道那些障碍在哪里。
So I have give you some examples here to kind of give you a visual of what they are. So when I see patients for the first time, So when I see patients for the first time, I just tell them the navigator. What the navigator is, if you are at a hotel and you don't know what to do, you're gonna die in zero. So that is what the navigator does. When you have something or you have questions, just look for the navigator.
Oh, can I have someone quiet over there? OK， 你看 ，OK， 他说嘛，抱歉，有点忘记。他说那个导航员啊，就是你当你在那个看什么哈，有什么阻碍的时候，有什么障碍的时候，他们是第一个要去找的人。
So the resources that I can utilize to overcome some of these barriers are going to be referring patients to our education center because we provide evidence-based education. So we don't want patients Googling because Google is going to take you to a rabbit hole that you don't want to be.
他说呢，在 MDS， 如果说你有各种的障碍或者困难的话，他会转介你到他们的自己的一个教育中心。他不太希望你们到那个网站哈、啊、去搜寻，因为他说那些搜寻到最后你都不知道到哪里去了，所以他会建议到他自己的教育中心。
I can refer patients to integrated services, and that is going to be oncology massage, oncology acupuncture, music therapy, counseling for nutrition.
他说他在 Anderson 他们有一个叫做综合的整合的医疗的单位。他说那些单位他们可以转介给他们去做针灸啊，做按摩啊，做一些其他的辅助的治疗。
We also have a large supportive department, supportive care department. This department focuses on quality of life. So it helps the patient to manage some of the symptoms, more common symptoms, which are nausea, fatigue, vomiting, pain.
他那个 他还有一个 Anderson 还有一个就是说，当病人的时候，在癌症治疗最后是疼痛啊那些其他的一个那个副作用造成一些很多影响的时候，他们有一种的那个 supporting 就支持的那个让你去减轻你的痛苦，减轻你的压力啊这方面的支持服务。
At counseling and support, our social workers also work with the patients providing that support.
所以在 Anderson 还有一个就是社会工作人员。社会工作人员也可以继续的帮助病人在做这方面的那个治疗过程中的一些阻碍。
And MD Anderson offers a faith-specific ministry for those religious needs.
他说 Anderson 他还有一个就是他们的宗教上的需要，病人有宗教上的需要，他们有这个部门专门来帮助病人在心灵方面的得到支持。
And we have designated praying spaces.For patients that are not English speaking, then we provide English services and we provide interpreters in every visit.
他说，如果说你不懂英文的，他们有语言翻译部门。像中文的，他们有自己聘请好几位讲中文的，或者是在那个电话上或者 iPad 上的中文翻译。
So everyone that comes to MD Anderson is going to be greeted by a team of specialists, and also is going to receive the support that they need to make sure that they are receiving the best care possible. If anyone wants to become a patient at MD Anderson, they can either do it over the phone or they can visit our website mdanderson.org.After they, when they're requesting the appointment, they're going to be asked any basic information.
Okay, that's okay. 他说 ，Anderson 哈，他们的当任何一个病人来，他们治疗 Anderson 是一个 team 的哈，是一个团队的，不是一个医生哈。那你如果要去看 Anderson 的话，你可以直接打电话去，或者直接到他的网站哈，就直接 Google Anderson， 直接到他的网站去那个。 登记就可以，不需要医生的 referral 啊。然后呢，他到时候你登记的时候，他会要一些基本的资料。
After the new patient referral has been initiated, a representative is going to communicate with the patient, and a nurse navigator is going to provide additional information and keep the patient's
information. 所以当你在电话上或是在那个网站注册以后呢，他们那个护士导航员就会跟你联系，联系要一些更就是额外的一些资料。Maybe Anderson 这点的服务非常好，用专业社方法帮助癌症病人，他们有24小时一定会有人打电话回来。I said you have 24 hours with your turn.
Yes.、Oh, yeah. And in the meantime, the representative is going to collect all the medical records, so when the patient see the doctor for the first time, they get the best out of that appointment because they have everything that is there.
所以当那个护士导航员给你打电话的时候，他可能会要一些更多的资料，因为那些资料会帮助他们去安排。
So I recommend everyone looking for care to advocate for yourselves. Ask questions. Ask what resources are available.You might be or might be not the first person asking for the resource.
他说啊，他建议每一个病人啊，当你要去安先生看病或是看病的时候，记得你是你自己的倡导者啊，尽量问一些问题，因为你可能不是第一个人问这些问题的啊，就为你自己的健康努力去找资源。
If you know anyone that is wanting to become a patient at MD Anderson, I invite you to visit our table. We have all the information. And for patients that are coming internationally, we do have an international center that will help with the visa and with the whole process.
他说他如果大家有兴趣的话，他待会在这边结束以后，他有他的那个桌子，他有很多的资源，你可以直接来问他。那其中有一项呢 ，MD Anderson 有一个国际中心。那个国际中心甚至可以帮那个病人啊做一些关于签证方面需要的一些帮助。
I will welcome your questions after the presentations, and I want to thank you the opportunity to present to you.
他说谢谢大家，让他有机会来这边分享 NDS 的资源。我们也谢谢他 ，Thank you。